Good afternoon, everyone. I think we have few more people joining. The number is increasing. We'll just wait for another 2 more minutes for everyone to join in, and then we'll start the session.
Sure, Shilpi.
In the meanwhile, since the others are joining in, I would just like to reiterate the fact that since this is a webinar and we have a very gorgeous Shailja ma'am here right away. So first, I would like to welcome Shailja ma'am. Good afternoon, Shailja ma'am. And
thank you so much, Shilpi. It's a pleasure to stay connected. Yeah.
So too. So to start with, I would just like to tell about Shailja ma'am. So Shailja ma'am, as we welcome you on the stage with us today on the webinar on the very fact that the teaching can be in any setting and the impact of the teaching should last wherever, whatever might be the setting. So welcome you warmly, ma'am. Telling about Shailja ma'am a little. So Shailja ma'am has got lot of academic laurels to herself, but apart from that, she's a passionate and a diverse leader with over 25 years of experience in school leadership. She has been an integral part of a school administration and academics and general arena. She has got a rich experience in heading 3+ schools as a founder principal. That's a great achievement, ma'am. And she is a mentor and an educator for even the teachers' education, that is the B.Ed. College for Bangalore University and Indira Gandhi Open University also. She believes in the motto, performance is work. So ma'am, with that note, we would like to extend our best wishes to you on the stage. And also now, since you are here, I would not like to take any further time, and the stage is all set for you, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Yeah, and such a warm welcome, Shilpi. I'm truly impressed. Good evening.
Before we start, ma'am, can I just, for the lovely audience out over there, I would just like to tell a few things. So since this is a webinar, everyone, you need to keep a few things in mind. You will not be able to chat with us physically, but yes, the chat box is all yours. Whatever questions come to your mind, if you see the ribbon down, there's a black ribbon, there it is written Q&A. All your questions should come over there. If in case we ask you any questions in between, the replies should come in the chat box. I repeat, please ensure you are sending us all your questions so that we can answer to each and every doubts that you have. Okay, without taking even a single moment, Shailja ma'am, I think we should commence the session now.
Yes. Thank you so much for that wonderful introduction, Shilpi. It's such a pleasure. Good evening to all of you. It's a pleasure and a privilege to connect to you all on this platform. Let's, take the pleasure to run through the most important aspect of teaching. Yes, it's very important that we understand that teaching has to be for engagement and should leave a lasting impression in any setting. Above all, effective teaching is effective teaching, no matter where it occurs. The best teachers are the ones who show you where to look, but don't tell you what to see. The biggest challenge for any teacher in today's world is capturing the attention of students and engaging them creatively. And it's also important that the learning that occurs leaves a lasting impression in each of them. So as a teacher, to be able to tackle this challenge effectively, one needs to implement innovative strategies and techniques. So how do we do this on a regular basis? And how are we to bring about, all the fun and enjoyable experiences while learning? over to Shilpi. Shilpi, can I request you to play a couple of videos?
Yes, surely, ma'am. So these videos basically aim at the various stages, cases where how the children are learning. Okay, so let's have a look at this video. I'm again sharing the video.
Today I'm going to show you a simple recipe for cookies. Let's start with the ingredients. You will need 3 cups of flour, 1.5 teaspoons of baking powder, 1 cup of butter, 1.5 cups of sugar, and 1 egg. First, mix the flour and baking soda in a bowl. Then, in another bowl, mix the sugar and butter. Next, add the egg and blend in the mixture from the first bowl. Finally, use a wooden spoon to put balls of the cookie dough on a baking tray and bake in the oven for 10 minutes. Allow the cookies to cool for a few minutes, but don't eat them all at once.
Listen and repeat. Hello and welcome to Claire's Kitchen. Today I'm going to show you a recipe for cookies. Let's start with the ingredients. You will need 3 cups of flour, 1.5 teaspoons of baking powder, 1 cup of butter, 1.5 cups of sugar, and 1 egg. First, mix the flour and baking powder in a bowl. Then, in another bowl, mix the sugar and butter. Next, add the egg and blend in the mixture from the first bowl. Finally, use a wooden spoon to put balls of cookie dough onto a baking tray.
Okay, so ma'am, there are 3 cases over here. Yeah. Now what you want us to do?
No, we would like the audience to tell us out of the 3 situations, which is a situation which brings about the best learner outcome.
So let's have a poll for them. So we launch a poll wherein we ask you 3 questions. In the 3 setting, where do you think the learning will happen maximum? Okay, so here goes your poll.
Very good, fantastic audience. Yes, now, but think before you answer. That's a little clue. The question for you is, which of the situations bring about the best learner outcome? Okay, so please do a little brainstorming.
All right, I think we can close in another 3 seconds. 3, 2. I think 80% of the audience have already given the response. Okay, so let's share the results with with everyone, what they have given. So they say that most of them say that the most effective way of teaching is when the child listens and they repeat what is being said. And then the second one is, there's a speech bubble version and the teacher is doing and showing. Ma'am, can we have a light on this from you and take us forward?
Yes. I think almost all of you are academicians and educationists and large number of teaching fraternity. It's very important that we can
bake in the oven for 10 minutes.
No issues. Yeah. So while we connect to learning experiences, it's important that we understand that all the experience that is enjoyable and filled with fun will truly bring about the best of learner outcome. So here again, the third one where the speech bubble approach is the occasion where there is true learning or the true sense of, the experience or rather the comprehension occurs. So let's move a little ahead talking about the learning in children. So how do children or people learn? What is learning? I'm certain we understand learning is a process of acquiring knowledge and skills. Yeah, it's also, it acts up or rather enhances your behavior and brings about a behavioral trend, sets in attitudes, and along with those cognitive skills. So while we talk about learning and the experience, it's essential that we connect the children to those fun and enjoyable situations. So here again, several occasions rather, we have understood that any learning that occurs, yeah, by doing, the outcome is more productive. Similarly, almost all the researches, or rather the scientific evidences, have proven that the hippocampus of a taxi driver is so wide and they can navigate much larger quantum of routes and directions. And that is because they are more often looking at it with those enjoyable remuneration that goes along. Yeah, so it's also important that we understand, while exposing children to those engaging classroom activities, it's essential to understand each and every child has an innate ability of learning potential. So it's important that as faculties that we are able to capture the optimum potential in each and every child. It's not just enough that, you know, we look at conveying the content or rather the ideas innovatively and engaging them actively. It's important to customize learning to each and every child.
That's very true, ma'am.
Yes. It's of utmost importance, failing which, you know, there would be a few kids who would be left behind in our classrooms. So we need to make a conscious effort to customize learning in the classroom.
So what do you feel, ma'am, that when an activity is done, what should be the design instruction for a teacher?
Yeah, we need to be, you know, creating the structure of a class, whether it is a physical session or a virtual session, the effective teaching has to occur. So no matter what is the platform that we are opting for, every child who stays connected with that learning exposure should be able to reap optimum benefit out of that situation. So for which we need to ensure that our classes are structured. Yeah, we need to definitely ensure that the content that is designed and implemented is effectively executed right from the start of the session until the end of the session. And it's also important that, you know, we regenerate them at the start of the session by using all the, you know, setting in those routines, setting, exposing them to the right learning culture. Yeah.
So that means when they are designing an instructional activity, it has to be a 10:2 pace activity, so
most
that
important, yes.
Most important, so that the children, by 10:2, you mean that 10 minutes of teaching followed by some two minutes of activity, so that the children are having a hands-on learning. That's
yes. So when the teacher is delivering the content, it's very important that, you know, that the teacher makes an adequate effort to remove the monotony. So say, for example, if you're about, you know, 6 to 7 minutes of your content delivery is occurring in a class, break the monotony by, you know, bringing about a 10:2 pace where you're, you know, interacting with children and bringing about effective learning trends there. So elicit answers with them from them, or rather connect to them with all the facts that you would want to recapitulate quickly. And it's also important that, you know, that you are not looking at, you know, the group of students that you're dealing with are children who are at different learning levels. You may have oral learners, you may have, you know, lingual learners, you may have social learners. Yeah, so it's very important that your content, or rather the quantum of learning that you are exposing them to, is able to reach up to each and every child. So remember, the group of students who are there with you are part of a mixed group. So try hard to customize learning to every child. It's only then that you will be able to meet up to the demands of children.
So ma'am, to do this, I think that there should be certain set norms. You were talking about that, norms, that there should be certain norms.
Talking about norms and classroom expectations, which is very, very, very important. Mm-hmm. You know, it is not just enough that, you know, we spoke about a school culture or rather a class culture, while we were imparting learning in the physical sessions. It's important that we set in those expectations, classroom norms in the virtual sessions as well. And for this, you need to capitalize the first 5 minutes of time, or rather, you know, between 3 to 5 minutes of time. And that initial phase of time, set in the routine for the class. Like, for example, you know, they need to be well informed, and there should be a routine where every child understands what is mute and unmute button. How would they use the chat feature and manage the chats? And also in the senior levels, or rather in the secondary levels, you would be able to expose them to the other learning trends of even the break room management. Set in a classroom rule, you know, at the start of the session, where the child understands that if the child is a speaker, the child has to focus on the camera while speaking. And also, if there is a question to be raised, let the child be taught that, you know, the hand raise option is possible. And also ensure that, you know, children are staying connected actively. They are engaging themselves productively. At the same time, they know that, you know, when to use the mute and the unmute button, which is very important. If they are not speaking, then they need to certainly mute themselves. So this feature management has to be by default taught to every child. So when you start off your session, the first 2 minutes that children are entering, that is the time that, you know, there should be a habit formation, setting in these class rules and expectations.
Ma'am, I think also when the first 2 minutes is like the hook, right? Hook the children to attract them to the class, right? So I know that you have a lot of, you know, fun-filled activities. So please take us through how initially you know, when the children are entering the class, how can the teachers engage the students much more creatively so that the children look forward to join the class?
Definitely. And it's very important that, you know, that we are able to motivate them and inspire them such that this inspiration lasts until the end of the session. Okay, different approaches to this. Exposing children at the very beginning. Okay, please take a good look at, you know, what is the way, what is the innovative approach that you can use to greet them while they are entering. Okay, and you need to also remember, it is just the first 2 to 3 minutes of your settling down time that you are looking at. Okay, so how would you relate to this? It could be anything connected with your subject. It could be something completely out of the box. Yeah, so make sure that, you know, even a simple approach to engaging them by, you know, while coming, when they are greeting in and settling down, even if you have a creative which is run behind you and that's creating an inspiration or other anticipation as to what is the topic for today. That is another way to engage children. Please remember, the social time has to be captured differently every day. You cannot have anything which is going to be a recurring experience for them. So introduce them to different ways of, you know, it's kind of greeting them and welcoming them, but also ensure that, you know, you're settling them down with that little spirit and enthusiasm for the class, or rather for the day.
Okay, so here are a few tips for the teachers, how they can start their day where the children can have more fun entering the class. Okay, so here goes the first one.
Yes, this is an amazing one. Yes, you know, as children are entering the class, if you are going to reflect different emojis and different expressions and you start scrolling through their roll numbers, you know, the child will look at his or her own roll number and start feeling, you know, energized over that. So some of them will try to retain the same expression on their face. Yeah, I think even as adults, if we are in a session, if we start doing this,
I want to do a welcome beat like this.
Let's see.
You know?
Yes. So, yes. And that expression definitely will, you know, bring about that enthusiasm in the other students as well. So yes. Please work along with, you know, such expressions, such greetings, which will, you know, energize them. Do not repeat anything. There is a world of, you know, ways that you can bring about in any class.
All right. Let's have some more look at one more strategy.
Yes. This is again another interesting way to greet children. Just, you know, while taking them in, if you could just say, you know, good morning and I have an awesome day or a pleasant day. After which you could just ask them, see, this is something which will bring about maximum energy and enthusiasm in them. Shall we
play? Kind of a recap, you know, the, like a previous chapter, they have done a concept and they want to recap it. So probably in this session, they can have some game like a missing link, which will be act as a hook to them, and this they can start the lesson.
True. And the minute you say, you know, let's play a game, the, you know, these students are overwhelmed with enthusiasm and spirit. Yeah. So most of the time we need to, you know,
I'm sure this is not limited to, you know, maybe one grade. It can be covered to all the grades. Okay, let's see how our teachers and all the educators out over there, how do they play? Let's play a game with them. Sure. How do they feel on this game?
Now we cannot leave them, you know, as silent spectators.
Yes, they have to be participative. Very true. Yes. So let's play a game with them. So there are missing links in the following slide. What you are supposed to do is, you're supposed to look at the link and write the answer in the chat box. Okay, so here we start. So guess the first link. What is missing over here? And put your answer in the chat box. Let's see, are the answers coming?
Yes. I think most of them are able to answer because I can see the chats coming, flowing. Very good. Lovely. We have fantastic audience. Yes.
Yes, lots and lots and lots. Mom, should we give them the answer? Most of them are on the right track.
Yes, all the answers are right.
Okay, yes, it is pan. We move on to the one more, ma'am. Let's see whether they are awake or not.
Yes, okay. Please do that.
Yeah, okay. The next one. Paper-cut.
Again, another very simple one. I'm sure most of them will get it right.
I again repeat, in case if you have any doubts or questions, please put your answers in the your questions in the question answers. All your doubts in the question answers and all your replies in the chat box so that we get all your questions and we don't miss any of them.
Any of it, yes.
I think they all are right, ma'am.
Almost all. I didn't see a single answer which is wrong. Fantastic audience you all have been.
Wonderful. So this is one way I think they can use all the concept that they have taught in the class with such kind of links they can create and they can ask, maybe they can start the class with a link. And this will energize the class also.
Yes. Because that active indulgence is what we are talking about. And we really hope that, you know, all of you will be able to take, you know, have your takeaways from here and you will effectively use them in class. Okay. It's also important that, you know, you think innovatively. You could come out with anything that you think is going to be, you know, effective while settling down. Like, for example, if you're running, you know, if you're part of a course subject, you could even raise a set of questions. You could also ask them to share a few things. Yeah. And while you say, you know, while you ask them to share, it could also be, you know, some emotions or something that was very important, you know, something that they connect to. It could also be running the headlines for the day. You could also ask them about, you know, how they feel and, you know, how was the day since morning to the class that they have attended as well. Could we give them some more samples of the activities, Shilpi?
Yes, ma'am. So the very first one, as we said, that ma'am said sharing of questions. So you can start with a thought or a question that was there in the previous class. Like, you know, here ma'am has kept one question.
Yeah, you could talk to them about, you know, this is something which is going to be highly energizing. Start of the session and, you know, the teacher wants to know whether I'm keen in going on a virtual tour or am I, you know, more keen in attending or rather visiting a water park.
So, okay, now the biggest question over here comes, ma'am, most of the time is that the teachers find it difficult. Whom should I give the chance to speak? Okay, yes, and those children are also like, you know, they're ready with their answers.
Yes, so it's very interesting if you start using a class wheel.
Okay, should we give them a demo of this, ma'am?
Yes, Shilpi.
Okay, so all of you can play together. Take a note of this. It is called as class wheel. Okay, this is something like a wheel of names. So we'll just play quickly over here. So I have a class wheel out over here and I can just run this out. Okay. So I get a name out over here. Okay, so this way I think I can again, I can remove the child or I can keep the child again, and then this will give a chance to other people also, and that again that child will not be bored that my name has come, now it will not come again.
Yes, so the entire class will be able to capture their attention, because that surprise element of, you know, whose name is going to occur from time to time is going to be the fun element there. So
yes.
Let's look forward for this.
Okay. So there are a list of handouts that we are now putting it in the, you know, there's a Google folder that we are sharing with everyone out there in the meeting. So you can have the list of the questions, the list of activities that we are going to discuss further. All that is there in this handout. You can always refer this whenever you want in your future, how to implement all these activities. Okay. So,
are we sharing all this?
Yes, yes, we are sharing, ma'am. Ruhi, can I request you to please share it on the chat window?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so let's move forward, ma'am. Let's see what you have more on your...
Some more energizers or, you know, some more activities that will be, you know, able to connect them effectively in class. Okay, so we're talking about, you know, simple approaches to bring about this excitement or motivation. I'm sure all of us understand it's very, very important to keep the children motivated. Yeah, whether it is first hour of the day or the last hour of the day, it's essential that we connect to that spirit and enthusiasm in children. Otherwise, there will be no true learning at all. So while you intend doing so, bring about the excitement by following any of these trends. You could also, you know, try to capture something that was taught earlier or something that is connected to the present topic in a game or in a mode, in a different mode. Even simple techniques like, you know, getting them to read or write or, you know, speak up for a minute or so will also engage them effectively. Since you have to have multiple approaches to energizing them on a regular basis.
Okay. Guys, more than energizing, it is also about, you know, ensuring that the children are participating in whatever class teaching is happening. So these activities, I don't think so, is related to other concept. It is basically with the concept that is being taught in the class. So ma'am has got pools of ideas here out, which we would like. So there are a lot of remote learning ideas. So it's not necessary that you are present in the physical classroom only where you can do the activities. Even in the remote learning setup that we have now, you have ample of activities which ma'am has brought in front of you. So ma'am, how should we go about, ma'am? Yeah. You want the people to decide?
I'll ask them, Shilpi. I will give them the option.
All right. So let's have a poll from all the teachers. Which one activity they would like to know?
Okay. There are about 12 activities that are enlisted. You are free to choose any one or two. Okay.
One only. And once we get the maximum poll, we will take those.
Sure.
Okay.
Almost all are running at the same.
Yes.
Come on, audience. You all have been the best. Yes, keep energize yourself and choose. Look at the name or the caption and try to connect. Okay. Yeah. Some of them are coming out with, you know.
Yes. 61% vote till now.
Yes. Lullaby or the, you know, the quick change, build a story also is going up.
Picture
memory is going up.
Oh, yes,
showing her eyes.
Yes, so we give them another 3 seconds. So 3, 2, and 1. There we close and share the results, what they would like to learn more. So maximum has voted picture memory. So we'll go with picture memory first, followed by 1 minute, please. And we have on 12, we have got build a story.
Okay, sure. So
and then alibi.
Then how many of them will we be able to show it to them?
Ma'am, I think now as they have pointed out, so we will go with 4 of them. So we'll go with picture memory. We will go with 1 minute, please. We will go with alibi. and build a story.
Okay, sure. Let's start with Alibai, is it?
And if we have time, we can take scavenger hunt. Okay, so let's start with Alibai first. Okay, ma'am, here you go.
Yes. So, what is Alibai? It's a game where the teacher sends private messages to one of the students. Okay, this student is going to be a perpetrator, and he would also be, you know, he would be the one who stole the cookies from the cookie jar. But another student is also chosen to be a detective. So now, how does the game go? Every person in the class gives his or her alibi, saying that, you know, quoting small phrases or small statements, saying that I was taking my dog to the vet and I haven't seen the cookie or whatever, so on and so forth. But at the end of it, we are asking the students to repeat the alibi. And that is the time the perpetrator reiterates differently. So if he has said, I had taken the dog to the vet, he would rather convert it to be a cat. And that's when the class has to connect to him, or rather, the detective has to connect to him. Yeah, so this is...
Yeah, I think this can be done with the concept also, right, ma'am? Like, for example, if it is, say, if it is an English concept or say a science concept, where I have made you as, you know, one of the person who has stolen the perpetrator, if I made you that, and then others have to say the sentences related to the subject, and the person has to detect whether the sentence is right or not right, and that's how it can be also connected. So it is not necessary that you have to have a, you know, it can be related to any subject also. It is just a link. It can be for any grade also. It's not grade specific that it cannot be played for higher grades or lower grades. It can be played for any grade. It can be played for any subject also.
Definitely, yeah. And if you're using it for core subjects, you could try and highlight terminologies or definitions. So that again will add color to the recapitulation of the content.
Yes. Okay, the second one that they have chosen is build a story.
Okay, this is also a very interesting activity, Radha. See, these students can take turns and they can start saying a word or a sentence. Okay, and each time that they say it, you need to ask them to build a story. So when everyone has completed their turn, you can ask them to re-attempt telling that story all over again. So that's when it becomes a class story, and you can highlight the fact that it is a class story. So you could say that, you know, in a short span of time, the class is so creative that they are able to build up a story.
So this is very good for languages as such, but I think even for concepts like social studies also, wherein you say if it is they are learning some war story, say World War One. So they can start with the first one says the first part, the second one adds to it. Maybe the sequencing could be done. Similarly, in science also, how the lesson was being built in, they can have the sequencing made the same way. We can have the class wheel rotated for the children, and each child whose name comes will fill in the next story. So wonderful, ma'am. Building a story, I think, can again be taken care of with all the subjects and possible.
They can use it. Yeah, they can use it irrespective of the subject, because it will really work as an, you know, energy building activity within the class.
All right. We move on to the next one, ma'am. That was picture memory that everyone has chosen. So okay. I'm clicking on picture memory next.
Yeah, that's also a very, very interesting game. Yeah, you will be exposing children to the picture initially. And for about a few seconds, yeah, you could take a call on how many seconds you want to, you know, display the picture. And the picture can be related to a theme also. If you think, you know, you are a social studies teacher or a language teacher, connect it to a theme. Or, you know, it could be a simple diagram of anything that is of concept oriented as well. So after showing the picture for the required period of time, that is whatever, maybe 30 seconds, 20 seconds that you intend showing it to them, close the picture and ask children to write or rather enlist as many items as they remember or rather they have observed. So this again will, you know, send in messages that yes, and ask children to send the messages, whatever they have observed, to in a private message to you. So this way you will get to understand who are the keen observers of the class?
For the lower grade, because the section strength is less, for 5 students are coming, they can directly ask also.
You can ask as well. Yes. Yeah, you could just have different images and, you know, smaller things, smaller substances, and then ask them to connect what all was scattered around. Yeah. That also will become a picture memory.
All right, ma'am, we take the last one, that is scavenger hunt now.
Yes. I thought we were also
Sorry, 1 minute, please. They have asked for. Sorry, 1 minute, please.
Okay. Fine. This is again a topic that you would give randomly, you know, to any child of the class. And you will ask the student to speak for one any particular topic without pausing for a minute. So it is almost, you know, probably something similar to just a minute, but you need to make it more creative. You know,
It can be related to the concept that is being taught. Maybe, yeah.
You could even expose them to a phrase or a word and then tell them, you know, that I want to see you use this thrice in the game, or thrice in your narration, or 5 times in your narration. So the child is more inspired to do so.
Ma'am, I think we can take scavenger hunt also. We have
A very interesting game. Yes. So here in this game, the teacher announces a description and the students in the class will find the item that is connected to. It could be something of a specific shape, or it could also be, you know, an item that, you know, that is connected with the topic. But please remember, whenever you're playing this game, enlist a set of expectations and conditions.
Yeah, so these are a few conditions. Yes.
Very, very important that, you know, you must inform children that, you know, they should not run helter-skelter. They must be wherever they are. And there should not be any chaotic condition. Yeah. Let them ensure that they're not using any item or any device which has a sharp object. They should not, you know, break any of the items. And they should be able to place those items back in the respective place.
And also, if they don't find it, is okay.
Perfectly okay. You can tell them that you can come back to class and see, you know, what others found.
Yeah, and there should be a timer also for it, that you have only 30 seconds to do it or something like that. Yeah, so there are a bunch of activities that can be done subject wise, like for if you are doing for Hindi and for say Marathi, means all languages, you can have like something adjective scavenger hunt. You have shiny object, colorful object, smooth object.
Wonderfully well, yes. For, you know, for the languages, Shilpi.
Yeah, and even for maths. So like, for example, measurements. So find which is 20 centimeter long.
Yeah.
Find something which is the width of the hand. So this is like totally up to the teacher how she wants to use these activities in the class to ensure that there is a lot of fun that is flowing in the class, because if there's fun, definitely children would like to come to the class. And this is not that this is some activity to energize. This is basically you are doing a recapitulation of your subject, what you're teaching.
Right. And also another way is, you know, connect them to multiple colors. Because whenever the minute you take, you know, the title or the caption of certain colors, the energy flows. Yeah. So that it is that positive energy that we are trying to capture in children. So if you talk about, you know, a rainbow scavenger hunt, and you tell them identify substances which are, you know, either in red or orange or purple or yellow or green, they would definitely have substances around them. And you could, you know, reiterate the guidelines so the children are able to grab themselves back to class.
All right, so let's move back. And now, ma'am, this is my favorite activity and I would like to play this.
Let's play it with the audience, Shilpi. Shall we connect them?
Yes. Yeah. We can ask Rahul to get 5 of the attendees to be the panelists. Rahul, can you help us?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's see the nominees.
I request people who would like to participate, please raise your hands. I will invite you. Make you as a panelist. The top 5 will be selected.
Yeah, 4 of them have already, 12 participants have already raised their hands. Rahul, this is again another amazing, set of people with us. Set of academicians with us. Fantastic. Okay. Very good. Welcome on board, panelists. Okay, I'll quickly, you know, run you through the guideline for playing this game. The teacher would read out the statements, okay? So if any statement is true for someone, they put up a finger. So the first one who raises all the 10 fingers up for the statements, if it is false, you're not going to raise your finger, okay? So if it is a true statement, then you need to raise your finger. So the one
I request the panelists out over here to please open up your camera, because then only we'll be able to see your fingers.
Otherwise, true, very true.
Yeah.
Okay, so can we request Smita, Parveen, Lavanya, and Miss Mayuri? I hope the game is very clear. Okay. When the statement is read, Shilpi would do the reading.
Yes, right, yes.
Okay, fantastic. So Shilpi will do the reading. And if the statement is true for you, then raise a finger.
All right. Okay. So here we go. Are we ready? I ate cereals for breakfast today. Is it true? Then you are going to raise your hand.
We need to
raise
see
your finger. Okay.
Yes. We need to certainly see your palm. Okay.
I am not wearing shoes.
Oh, okay. Okay.
My finger goes up.
Okay. Okay. I have somebody there. Okay.
I read a story before bed last time. I read a story
before bed last night. Okay. Just connecting to the previous night. Okay. Did you read a story? I have written a poem this week. Not at all. I haven't done it at all.
I have taken a nap this week. Yes.
Okay.
I have broken something this week.
I've broken something at home this week. Okay.
I listened to my favorite music this morning.
I have listened to my favorite song today.
I haven't watched TV
today. At all. I haven't watched any TV today. Not at all. Okay. This becomes true very often. I had dessert more than once this week. Okay. So many fingers. Who's the winner now?
I have dirty dishes in my bedroom right now.
No.
Okay. So that's all. So I think that can be reiterated with the children if you want to get out some facts from the children in terms of homework doing. You know, if the children have done homework, I like doing homework or something, some statements around that, and that will help children to connect with you, and you will know whether the children are finding the homework difficult. Like, I enjoy doing homework. I do it homework because I'm scared of my teacher. So something related to homework, if you keep making and putting it in the sentence, like, you know, like this, you can have five also.
Yeah.
So what will happen, you will come to know the emotions of the children, why they are not doing the homework, or why are they not submitting the homework, and that will definitely
also,
help you
yes,
to connect with them.
Yes. And also subconsciously, you know, they would start recalling what was the game that was played, and, you know, try to cover up those things which probably, you know, is the main feature of that day. So if it is connecting to homework, certainly a child who hasn't submitted will look at it at the end of the day. So, okay. And also, other than this, we could also run them through certain themes that we can connect to.
I think let's thank the all the attendees, those who were here. I hope you're having fun.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, great.
Lovely, lovely. So good.
Thank you so much to be active participants. We move back now to our topic. Yes, ma'am, over to you.
Sure. So we were discussing a lot about, you know, bringing about effective engagement in class, be it physical or virtual sessions. Now let's quickly run through the other mode of operation for energizing children at the start of the session. We can also work along with, you know, while setting in the norms and expectations, we could also ensure that there are special days in the school. Like, you could connect it with a theme. It could be connected to the subject as well. You can have any theme which is exclusive and, you know, it stands alone, stands apart from the content that you would be dealing. You could also connect it to something that is subjective as well. Say, for example, if all the days of the week can be captured differently, not necessarily all the days, okay? So you could do something for Monday, do something for Wednesday, and then, you know, keep the anticipation or expectation rather in store again on Friday.
Okay, so let's have a look at how you can handle the spirit of your class on all the days and ensure that your children love and look forward to your classes. And there is a lot of issue related to, most of the teachers have complained, I don't get attendance in my classes. The attendance is very low. Okay, so how do you ensure that there is attendance unless and until you do not have certain kind of books with your for your students, yeah, right? True. So I here Shailaja ma'am has put up a few good theme days. For each day, she has come up brilliantly with certain ideas. So let's explore each day a little. Okay.
Make the day special, especially Monday morning blues have to be removed. Yeah. So how would you do it? So see how you can, you know, here we have a wonderful way to energize them on a Monday. Move it Monday. Shilpi, will you be able to play a song?
Let's. Yes. So basically, so there are lots and lots of videos that are available on the net, which has a lot of energizers into that. In case if you find them good. If you don't find energizer, there are a lot of energizers that we have already spoken about in past also. In the future also, we'll be sharing with you few energizers, okay? So these energizers can be used in the, you know, to begin the class or maybe to dance. Or nowadays, the most in thing is Tabata. Children love Tabata. And there is something like, Avengers. So Avengers is something children are very, very fond of, right? So you can have,
something for us.
Yeah, I'll play. Okay, so here is a Avenger workout, which you can do with your children.
Hey guys, today we are trying Adapted Mind. I'm so excited to try this game. I've heard really good things. We're looking for a game for my niece.
I think it took only 20 seconds or a 40 second or maximum 1 minute for the class to be energized. But there can be more fun way in which we can always do such things. But yes, this is one technique to ensure you have Move It Monday.
Yeah. And this will bring a world of difference. And if the teacher is going to, you know, also move herself with some actions, then the energy levels would be, you know, tremendous. So I really hope all of you who are connected today will try implementing these activities, right?
And if you are not those active kind, you can have light energizers like breathe in exercises. Those are also like, it's also a part of yoga and things like that. So you can name each day of your day and you can start with that also as or towards the end of the class or somewhere in between. Find 1 minute out and do some activities. Children will be reminding you, ma'am, today was Monday and you've not done that.
Yes.
You can have some games also that can be Monday mind games, which you can play, like, you know, wherein which is related to your subject only, but it's a mind game.
Yeah.
Tuesday can be another way. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, Tuesday again, you know, you could play something, you know, which is a teamwork or a group work where they are able to connect to each other so that whatever that you are expecting is narrated or descriptively, whatever may be the manner. Other than this, there are loads and loads of ways that, you know, you can start your session, telling them that, you know, every Tuesday I will share a joke with you. So they would, the minute they enter, so they start the class in anticipation with, you know, there is something that is going to be a surprise element from the teacher. So it is that surprise element will drive them towards the learning of that R. So I think we need to be able to do this, spend this time together. See, there are some Tuesday activities that, you know, that we have enlisted here. Are we giving them even these lists in the...
No, these are not there, but these can be very, very easily created. These are something which I am sure they are more creative than us.
Yes, okay. So on Wednesdays, because I was earlier also connecting to Wednesdays being a no-bag day, so children certainly are looking forward for activities, yeah, which are very different from the regular days. So if you can bring in that element of, you know, that spirit or enthusiasm, like say, you know, all Wednesdays we will do this. Like for example, Wear It Wednesday. If you're going to connect to a particular theme or a color code, or the even a simple thing of like now uniform, we have not made it mandatory. So even if you tell them like, oh, this Wednesday we'll come in our sportswear, that will trigger children up. Also, you could also play, you know, certain games, like certain outfits and say, let's come again. Let it be a pajama day or let it be a superhero day. Whatever may be the attire that you want to present yourself with, come in that.
Wear It Wednesday.
Yes, Wear It Wednesday.
We can have tricky Thursdays where we have brain teaser. Yes. We start the class with a brain teaser. Let's have a brain teaser with all our teachers out there.
Yes.
Let's see. We would like you to please answer to the questions in the chat box. Okay. What is this?
Okay. Yeah. These are very simple tricks that, you know, that you could throw across to children. And the simpler they are, you know, more the energy level is going to be. Right. Fantastic. Yes. All the answers.
Okay. We move on to the next one.
Yeah, let's see the next one. Yeah. Yeah, one or two are, you know, marking it right.
Because they're going with the previous one.
Yes.
Yes.
There are a large number of, yeah, many of them are able to get the right answer.
Yes, tricycle, they're right. This one.
Let's see with this.
See, now also when you are replying, how the spirit is going up, right? In between, if you have certain things like this, definitely the children will be attracted to you and they will do, especially from grade 3 onwards, even in the lower grade 1 and 2, if you have small words, definitely they can take do this. Okay, that's all, ma'am. Now coming to Friday.
Fantastic, most of them, yes. Fridays have always been, you know, fun-filled. So try hard to play a game. Make sure that, you know, your simple techniques like, you know, changing your background, changing your, you know, your Zoom creative, or making them guess where you are. And you know, there are umpteen ways that you can keep them engaged. You could also make it a field trip day. This is, again, probably, you know, children will be happy about it. Yeah, a weekend, and then you're telling them, let's go on a field trip, and you could expose them to different things. Do you want to visit a zoo, or would you like to be, you know, in an aquarium, or do you want to see a museum, or shall let's have a virtual tour to an island?
Okay. Ma'am, can you just, you know, most of the teachers want to know, how is this different from bind and wind?
You cannot connect this to bind unwind at all, because bind and unwind is a specific time slot and a specific theme.
So this is for all the user, all the people who are viewing, other than Orchids teachers. So bind and unwind at Orchids is a wonderful activity where the teachers get, you know, their students get a time slot of 20 minutes where they have social interaction with each other through certain activities. Now, those are timed 20 minutes. So, Shailaja ma'am is telling us, how is this different from those bind and unwind?
Yes, ma'am. And that is also, you know, a snack break for children. So, while they are narrating, you know, whatever may be the theme that we give, they are also having those light moments by sharing, or, you know, by having their meal together. Yeah, so here again, this is exclusive. I know the bind and unwind sessions are theme-based, and that's a short duration of time. And a specific topic is given to them. So children are coming out innovatively, but they're connecting to the theme or the topic. But here, we are asking you to explore into that world which is unknown. make sure that every Friday you're, you know, trying to add a fun.
I think this will hardly take them 2 minutes or 3 minutes of their time. And that is a longer duration of a 20 minutes or a 30 minutes. This will not take that teaching time away, but yet keep them.
This can also come in between the session. It's most essential to start the session with this so that, you know, whatever learning quantum that we are expecting, you are able to productively bring about that.
All right. So I think...
Okay. So it's very, very important that we understand that, yes, we are teaching in the virtual platform and it's a time of crisis. But I'm certain that, you know, our children, when I say our children, children at Orchids, the international schools in the past 4 months or 5 months have never, ever felt, you know, the time of crisis at all. Neither will we ever permit them to feel it. Yeah, it's a challenge that, you know, that we would continue to run through until such time that we are able to bring them back to the physical sessions. Our virtual classrooms and the interactions and these sessions have been highly effective. So we believe in that, you know, that even our virtual sessions have to be structured and they have to be delivering the theory and the content effectively. Since we also set in those rules and expectations, we ensure that the learner outcome is productive and remarkable. So what is that that we are focusing on? Yes, as always, we have, you know, shown those progressive trends which are very unique and distinct for the establishment. So those of you who are connected with us today, I have just one message for you: rise above the rest. And let that consistent effort to rise above the rest continue. So over to y'all for an open forum. Yeah, no, Shilpi?
Yes, I'll just stop sharing right away. Yeah. All right. So we have loads of questions that are there, ma'am, over here. Okay. We'll start with... would you like to know about the wheel, how to add names and how to use it? Can I explain them? This one, ma'am?
Yes.
Okay, I will share my screen again. All right. So this is in my window. I have just written over here. Can you see wheelofname.com? All right, now there is a window that comes over here. I can just remove the names over here. The wheel becomes empty. I can start writing the names over here. Like, for example, I'm just writing Shailaja ma'am's name. I am entering my name. I wrote my name wrong. Then I enter Ruhi's name. She's again here from L&D department. And then I have Rahul over here to help us out. So these are the four people. Like this, the list can go on. So if you have 40 children, your names can come over here. And that's all. Now I can sort this list. There's a sort. So this can come as A to B. Or I can shuffle this list also. I can also add an image also over here. If you want your students' photographs to come over here, you can add an image also of the students over here to make it more creative. Now, what you have to do is, you will have to just run it in full screen and then click anywhere. So it will swing.
Yes. Yeah.
So if my name has come, so I will have to answer to the question. If I want to remove this child, I can just click on remove. So can you see only three students are left? If I don't want to remove, I can let it be there and just close it. So this is how it functions. I'll stop share. Yeah, I hope I've answered to your question.
Yes, it was really, really very clear. And you know, there are some more questions that have been flowing in here.
Yeah, I request again, if you have any questions, please put them in the question and answer so that we can reply to your questions. Yeah.